This is a 220 volts geared DC motor. Now this is the RPM at 60 volts and this is its full RPM at 220 volts. Now if we compare its power with DC motors of similar sizes, it is only 50 watts while others are peaking to as high as 1 kilowatts, 1000 watts. Another point is this one cannot operate at 12 volts, which is very important for a DC motor. And guys, I got another panel from Loom Solar. It is 125 watts and 12 volts. Now guys, when I'm going to connect this motor, okay, one is already connected, one wire. Now this piece is not working because its voltage is very high. So obviously it is not going to work. If the voltage had been lower, it could have started running. So let's modify its winding. Now guys, I have removed all the previous copper winding and I'm going to use this thick copper wire. Let's measure it. You see 0.92 mm. So I'm going to use this one and then turn it into a 12 volts high current DC motor. I'm planning on giving it maximum possible turns per pole for maximum core utilization and power for this motor. Now you can see I've already removed the insulation. Copper is very thick and it's going to be a little difficult for me to manage it over here. And here, as you can see, that I've used two commutator slots as one single commutator, unlike the previous case. Now guys, to make sure that I have given correct number of turns per pole, I'm going to do the resistance check. So yeah, all the poles seem to be fine. So let's assemble it back and test it. Now, because I'm using much thicker winding than before, so the current rating is going to increase considerably, and for that reason I should change the motor wires. And here, as you can see, that I'm using these two 4mm cables. Next level. So now that the assembly part is fully complete, let's test it. So guys, this is my solar panel and I'm going to do the current testing, short circuit current testing now with my multimeter. The current is on and let's short circuit it and then connect my clamp meter. Yeah. And here we have around 4 amperes, 3.96 and fluctuating. So I think that should be enough. Oops, I was covering up my solar panel. My mistake. So here, as you can see, that it is producing 5.36 amperes, which is very good. It is also not very sunny right now, but still it is generating around 5.3 amperes. Brilliant. Let's test my modified DC motor with it. And you see that I've connected this piece. This connecting piece is of rubber and this is of metal, so it is going to be a little bit shaky, but let's test it. Okay, so I'm connecting the motor wires finally. Oh, one wire connected. Let's hold it with clips. And finally, the last one, and it should start. And here it is running really good. Wow. And nice performance and superb high torque. Unstoppable. So that's my solar panel, 120 watts, 125 watts, and it is powering up my high current DC motor. Let's measure the amperes it is drawing. At present it is only 1.3 amperes. So it is pretty efficient. No load, current is very less. And guys, now as you can see that it is also working with my 12 volts battery with a no load current of only 0.85 amperes at 12 volts. So it is even less than 12 watts, which is quite efficient.